Never mind that chipped magnet on there. Key still works. Sounds pretty good. Add a little extra noise, but we can deal with it. Didn't mark this one very well. So let's do that. Marked the wrong side. Space heater's on, so I guess we'll cut that out for a minute. Sounds like everything's pretty good over here. Okay, maybe three can get moved. Those all sound pretty good. What's up with that? One is it? I don't understand, they all sound good. So which one of these sounds bad? think I just fucked those up. This all sound clicky. Come on, buddy. There we go. That's a picked MCS. Finally. Fuck you, MCS. Get picked. I hate you. Finally. Let's gut it. Ooh, well, that was, I'd say that was fun, but it wasn't. I don't even care about the rubber band. I'm just happy this is over. Take a look at tools in a minute. Okay, see that's free spinning. Picture of that, because that was a jerk. Hope y'all don't mind. All right, now let's gut it. key still works. Okay, shaking a little bit, but hey, comes with the territory. We didn't need that on the table anyways. We can just leave that on the floor. Now, there's going to be a little key control pin in here, so just to make my life easier. Don't really have to add the shim, but just makes it so I don't have to stick a pick in the back. Drop plastic bit, plastic bit. Sidebar. Sidebar, ball bearing. Oh, some of those key control guys, because those things just flap all over the place. Something like that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, that was a fun first magnetic lock. Alright, and I pulled it out that way, so that should be this side. I bricked this once. I'll show you how I fixed it after. Now that I'm shaking really well, there's our crappy little sidebar doodad, which is actually kind of an interesting mechanic, I'm not gonna lie. Alright, there's our rotors for one side. Got mastered in the back with one mastering, the rest are not mastered. Okay, there's one side. Let's do the other side. Did I get under both? Yep, probably. There's that. There's that. And this side we've got. You can see this one's got two true gates, one true gate, one true gate, one true gate. There's our plug. All of our rotor chambers. Key control slots. This just has this little guy in it. And what happened to me is I took one sidebar out and I had turned the core and this key control or key core retention, you can see fell. And I didn't have the sidebar in, so it just fell in this slot. And I kind of bricked the lock like that. So what I ended up doing was drilling a hole. You can see it right up in here. And I pulled the spring out the top, because it's like the top of where that sits in. So I pulled the spring out, got this to fall all the way down, and then I could actually pull the core out. So that's how I unbricked it. You can see, maybe if I put the light better, that. All right, so that's the core. Sidebar sits down these on either side. The sidebar actually moves in and out, not compressing. So those little tabs line up with the true gates, and then this slides forward. When this slides forward, it's attached to a little prong. The sidebar that goes to the first rotor, and then this whole thing is kind of sprung, and it'll compress in and slide past the notches in the core. It's actually really a lot of machine work to get that all to sit like that, which is really interesting to me. But so yeah, there's MCS picked. I'll show the other little tiny sidebar to make sure everyone can see all the nubs are still there. There's all of our stupid little key control wafers. Don't really impact picking, besides they're annoying. That is mastered rotor. A different example of a mastered rotor. Unmastered rotor. See that one true gate? So, two mastered rotors, six non-mastered. EVVA MCS. I didn't really find this to be a challenge in the aspect of skill building. I found it to be a challenge in the aspect of persistence. So what you're listening for is when you have a rotor lined up, it will, the true gate will click on this, and that's what I'm listening for. If it doesn't make any, if the rotor doesn't make any noise, that means it's rubbing against the side. Once you rotate it around a little bit, you'll find the true gate. True gate will make it have a nice little jiggle. If it's not binding at all, it just makes a swishy circular sound. And if it's in the true gate, it makes a nice kind of crisp. You could probably hear with the pickup I had. It makes a much crisper sound. But anyways, that's EVVA MCS. Happy to have that done. Showed everything. Tools I used, method from Rainer. So there's only 8 biddings, or 8 technical directions. So I made picks each direction. Well, this one I made, and then they came off, but I didn't need it. So, because the one I used one pick for like one whole side. And then I have a positive, and a negative. So, 2, a positive, a negative, and then a whole bunch of plus minus rearranged in 8 little pie pieces. Piece of anti-magnetic strip, which I wasn't sure if it was working good, but can just stick both of those. I think that's supposed to work, otherwise they would be repelling. So pretty sure it worked, obviously. Well, that's 38 minutes. If you stayed this long, I appreciate you, and cheers. Do a little close up. I guess my camera's just gonna fall out, so that's as close as we're gonna get. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. Cheers. Talk to you later.